Check, check. Is that better?
You sound like you're coming through a fucking drive-thru.
Really?
Yeah.
What if I'm farther back from the mic?
I guess it's a little better.
Check. Is that better?
No. Yeah. It's a little better.
Check, check.
It's a little better, but your dick is small, to be clear.
Why does it sound bad?
Should Did you the drop key? It?
No. Check, check.
Yeah, that's better. You Is turn that the better? Gain. You turn the gain down, maybe.
I turn the gain down.
Nice.
Okay. Yeah. For some reason, it was turned up. I don't know why. All right.
Because of your little fucking prick. Oh shit! You got Fuddruckers on the head and Fuddruckers in the background, Nick.
Yeah.
Big respect.
This is the kind of shit we should be doing before exactly 3 p.m.
Yeah.
Yeah.
For not only future reference but also past reference.
Literally the last show we did.
Yeah, when we said
hey, it was agreed.
Yeah, let's try to get this going by make sure everything's good to go by 2:55. It was a 5-minute window was all you had to.
So maybe try 2:53 next time.
No. 2:55 is fine, I think.
Yeah. I understand it's Rosh Hashanah. There's other things going on.
We're constantly doing different Rosh Hashanahs.
Yeah. Rosh Hashanah. Does anyone say it like that?
Rosh Hashanah.
Rosh Hashanah. Yeah.
Rosh Hashanah. What's Rosh Hashanah? The Day of Atonement?
No, that it's the New Year. Yom Kippur is the Day of Atonement.
15% off. Passover is 25% off.
Yeah, nice. It's like different tags at a thrift store.
Yeah, Passover is the day that Circuit City went out of business and they did an 80% off liquid. Rosh Hashanah was the holy day of sticks and stuff liquidating.
Wow.
What's that, a furniture?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. That's where Moses got all the stuff for the fucking, the little shit with the ram. What's that shit called?
The shofar?
No, not the shofar. Didn't he have like a treasure chest?
Yeah, he did. Yeah, he had a tabernacle.
What was in that motherfucker? What was in the treasure chest? I don't know,
some gold. They made him carry it around for 40 years in the desert.
Yeah, well, he was just in the desert.
Did you guys notice I trimmed my mustache?
Did you?
You can see my mouth now.
Oh, I guess that's true.
Oh, yeah, you do. Yeah, you look better.
I trimmed the eating area. So I shoved all my hair in my mouth, and then I just used the razor on to cut it out, and then I spit all the hair out.
That's fucking gross.
That's how you have to do it.
Yeah, it's weird. It looks your face looks better, but now the bottom looks like
oh, this
out of place.
Well, it's because it's all frayed.
You got to put some oils in there, Daddy.
Shit, I didn't. I slept 3 hours last night.
Shit, what were you up to?
I don't know. I just woke up.
You want some manic shit? You've been working on shirt ideas.
No, I just didn't sleep well.
I'm not sleeping either. It sucks. I get up at like 5 every day.
Talking about me.
Okay, continue. So we're sharing.
We were discussing mine.
So what else is going on with you?
It was rude of me.
Yeah, I had breakfast this morning.
That's awesome.
Adam?
Yes.
Coffee down, please.
Come on, I'm trying to listen to what Nick had for breakfast, Adam.
That's true.
I'm trying to talk about Fuddruckers here. I was making Fuddruckers at home for breakfast, and I hurt myself. I haven't been sleeping well. I hurt one of my balls making Fuddruckers at home. Hello, police.
Police?
Police, I've hurt one of my balls making Fuddruckers.
One of my testicles has been stuck in a cast iron skillet. Please send your best man over here.
I need the essential workers to come here immediately. I've hurt one of my balls making Fuddruckers at home.
I was trying to make an ostrich patty like I was from Fuddruckers, and it was so dried out, I threw it on the ground.
I was, like most people in quarantine, I was missing my American right, my constitutional right to access Fuddruckers. Thomas Jefferson said, I shall visit the salad bar unmolested.
Absolutely.
That's true.
I'm about to molest Sally. I'm about to get some pussy from Sally and then go to the
Constitution is that you're not allowed to be molested.
Dude, I love doing shit unmolested.
Yeah.
I hate when I'm trying to do my American rights and then someone puts a thumb in my ass.
Uh-huh.
When I'm trying to stop a British guy from being quartered in my house.
Yeah.
And then somebody, and then fucking the government puts a thumb in my ass molesting me.
That's so annoying.
Benjamin Franklin had his asshole licked by an older gentleman when he was 8. And that's why he had to invent stuff.
That's why he's such a fucking freak.
Yeah. That's why he was like, fuck this shit. I'm going to kill myself with a kite.
Oh, so he was mad. He was trying to get electrocuted so hard he wasn't going to be gay anymore for being molested.
Yeah, I'm going to put the stove in the middle of the living room to kill myself, and then it didn't work.
It just warmed his house.
Warmed his house.
I'm about to make milk punch to kill myself with milk and fucking booze at the same time.
Poured all of the wine in his house in the glasses and set up a pulley system so he could drink all the wine at once. And then somebody came over. They're like, what's that? He's like, oh, it's my new piano.
Yeah.
Like, that's not a piano. It's 35 glasses of wine. He's like, yeah, no, it's an instrument.
Oh, dude. Yeah. Watch this. Ooh. Yeah. Ooh, bitch.
In 15 years, 100 years from now, everybody's going to be playing this thing. Of course, it's a musical instrument.
You guys don't know who Prince is, but that a guy like that is going to love it.
No, I'm not drinking myself.
I'm not going to kill myself.
Nah, it has nothing to do with that thing I put in the Constitution about being molested. Just put that.
Hey, Ben, you keep saying at the end of every amendment you want it to not be molested.
All the founding fathers are just putting their personal issues in there.
You shall have the right to bear arms and not have your penis ridiculed by your wife.
I don't want any of these British faggots in my house. That rule number 3. Say, no more British fags sleeping on my couch. My roommate always has his British friends over. I pay rent and I'm not using my Xbox. I don't want them here.
Every once, you know, maybe a weekend a month, sure, but every day?
Yeah.
No British homos. Mm-hmm. Isn't one of them that you have to pay back a loan over $20 or some bullshit?
I don't know.
I put that one in there.
One of them is really stupid.
That was Franklin Benjamin who put
Yeah.
No, I'm a different guy.
I'm different.
I saw that there was a sign out front that said free luncheon, and I just see if my name happens to be on the list and pass by a free luncheon. And by chance it was. So I came in. My suggestion is that you have to pay your loans back.
Under $20. Listen, I'm not crazy. $17, let bygones be bygones. I'm not like one of those Jews.
Is there dip for the crudité? Is there any dip for it? Or can I take it home?
Who let this man in here?
Can I take some of the crudité dip home with
me? Take whatever you want. Please leave.
How about we put a thing in here that says we have to give all our money to Israel?
That doesn't exist yet.
Well, can we just remember that for later?
Oh, right. I'm sorry. We haven't told you guys about that yet. My fault.
Yeah, we'll just put it in so when you read it backwards, it says you have to give all your money to Israel.
Oh, right. We haven't orchestrated the Holocaust yet to get Israel yet.
Yes.
My fault.
The plan hasn't gone into effect. It's going to be another 150
years. I'm 150 years ahead. My bad. Franklin Benjamin.
Benjamin sneaking his way in
for one of those legendary free lunches when they wrote the Constitution.
Yeah. You get a pint of Sam Adams and there's deli meats out and they got a sandwich from Jersey Mike's.
What was the spread back then, man?
At the Constitutional Convention?
Yeah.
Probably meads.
Is this shit cut out for you too, or is it just me?
No, I hear.
No.
No, it hasn't.
Okay. Yeah, my internet died. A lot of people know this, but my internet died right as we were finishing the
last episode. Got it in just under the wire. Through the wire, we did the last episode. And then Nick's internet cut off because he was downloading too much child porn.
Yeah, it sucks because it's like there's literally only one option for internet here.
Mm-hmm.
And I mean, it would almost be better if they just told you to go fuck yourself because it's like, you know, you like, what are you going to do? Not have the internet?
Yeah. They got you so by the balls.
It's just
I had a roommate that had a dispute with the internet company when I lived in DC, and they hung up on him because he was being too rude, and we had to get cell phone internet. We had to get like 4G signal into our basement apartment, and it just never worked. And he, because he refused to apologize to the cell phone company.
The cell phone or the internet company?
Or the internet company, yeah.
Damn.
We had to get like it was the worst internet in the world.
What did he say?
He called the lady a stupid cunt. I was like in the room. I was like, give me the phone. He's like, you don't have to be such a fucking cunt about it. You guys know this. You guys have met this guy before.
That's so fucking funny. Calling a lady a cunt.
He's like too proud to apologize to fucking Time Warner Cable or whatever.
So now, I mean,
they are the worst companies, but
yeah, for sure. I want some fucking RCN. They don't got that shit in Astoria. They almost do. All we have is
what
Time
is
Warner.
RCN?
It's some other cable shit. I don't fucking know.
It works better?
That's what people say.
Yeah, my shit. Yeah, I think where Nick and I live in Brooklyn, it's only Optimum.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. It's just Optimum. Damn, dude. I'm over here drinking your little beet sludge, Nick.
Yeah, how is it? Sorry, I didn't respond to you.
Not bad.
Very important email.
What was it?
I've been selected to participate in a survey.
Whoa, dude. For real?
Top prize for being the best of the survey is a girlfriend from the Orient.
That's really incredible, dude.
Is it the census?
As you know, I haven't been getting any pussy because of the quarantine.
Right, right, right. Yeah. The only reason is the quarantine.
It's yeah. The girls don't like me because it's the quarantine. They're worried about the coronavirus.
It's happening to a lot of kids.
Because they heard about all the pussy I used to get. Got it from that, from all those girls.
You know about all that, my philandering.
Right. With no wife.
Yeah, my swashbuckling and philandering. And so they're like, man, I wish I could come give pussy, but, you know, everybody's quarantined by law. Down by law.
Yep.
And so therefore I just now I respond to spam emails.
So now you got a survey that's usually sent out to guys.
Imagine is like some like 52-year-old man who's like new to computers just responding pissed off to every single spam email he gets. Like, you must think I was born yesterday.
Free Ray-Ban sunglasses.
I'll have you know, I don't know you from Tom, Dick, or Harry, but I've worked at fucking Batteries Plus for 25 years. And if you think that a district manager of my caliber and esteem would fall for, well, I got a Brooklyn Bridge to sell you, pal. And let me tell you, it's just a fucking robot. Just emailing robots all day long.
A bridge would be nice to own. I know that saying, I got a bridge to sell you, but wouldn't it be cool to own a bridge?
Wow.
You could just fucking sit up there by yourself. Nobody fucking, one can cross.
You could get pussy from the girls on the bridge.
You get pussy on the bridge. Yeah, there's a lot of options.
You get bridge pussy.
You get bridge pussy. You could bungee jump off it.
You'd have to deal with them damn trolls underneath the bridge.
Well, you get to shoot whatever troll under the bridge.
Dude, I wish I could shoot my trolls. That's for damn sure, brother. Shoot those.
Do you have people trolling you?
No, not really. I don't think so. I mean, always, but I don't think so.
nothing too.
I stopped paying attention. Yeah, nothing out of the ordinary. Just your.
I feel you, dog.
Just your average, you know. Just get it. Go to the camps.
Yogi Bear would say, "Just your average fucking bear." Didn't he say something like that?
Smarter than your average bear.
That's I don't remember that. I remember the picnic basket though.
I'm just a bear over here.
I'm a fucking bear. I'm a regular ass fucking bear over here, but a little better.
I'm just fucking don't look at me. That's what he said, right?
Don't make fucking eye contact with me.
Don't piss me off. Who is Yogi Bears? I would love to have a trivia show where you don't have to get the answer right. You have to guess whatever I'm thinking.
That's good.
I like okay. That. Yeah.
You know, it's like.
So you don't say anything.
Yeah.
You're just sitting there.
You're just silent.
Yeah. Someone's like, you want lunch? No. Get off the show.
You're off.
Yeah. Episode 52 over. No winners.
No winners. And we're going to have your balls removed.
Money is burned.
Money's burned in front of children.
You're
dying.
Just sitting on a pile of money.
Dying children, they just love cash. They're just going to children's hospitals bringing cool cards. Opening a briefcase and some just slam down on the hospital bed. My lungs! My lungs!
Shut the fuck up.
Shut up and smell the cash.
Smell the cash, bitch.
Hold our cash. Not by being a pussy.
You better hope this guy fucking thinks of what I'm thinking of.
When we got back from Iraq, we knew we wanted to do something with either charity or coffee. The problem with both is that they're both gay. All the coffee has been unfed by other veterans. So we do make a wish, but fuck you style charity.
Mm-hmm.
We're going to show these kids how they would get treated if they were in Iraq.
If they happen to be born in Iraq instead of America.
One of us. One of the devil brothers. Devil brothers from hell have come back. Hell, doing hell shit. To say to good white children. Mm-hmm. White meaning American, not white, nationally white.
Mm-hmm.
We don't mean racially white.
It's not racist.
Look, you ask me, brother, as long as you're fucking, you got one hand up towards the American flag, you're white to me. I mean this.
I meant the one by your saluting by the eyebrow, not out in front.
I mean the one that we're supposed to do. Whoops.
Whoops. No, I'm not a Nazi, psych. Yes, I am. Nope, psych.
It's part of my just kidding mentality.
I didn't know those kinds of guys were big kidders.
No, those guys are hilarious. They're some of the funniest guys.
Part of my just kidding lifestyle.
Mm-hmm. Yes, sir.
You never know when I'm joking around.
Let's say, yeah, in Iraq, you really learn how to laugh for the first time.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah,
at all the suffering that you caused.
Bringing a fucking Humvee to a kid who's got leukemia. It ain't yours.
Where's John Cena?
Yours. John Cena's behind you, pushing you, making you step on the accelerator. Let's do 95 and a 30.
That's not John Cena.
You got to prove that you're not a P-U-S-Y.
I'm getting cold.
Yeah, it's because your blood sucks. You got nothing but what do you got in those veins? You got fucking menstrual fluid in there.
He rips it out of his fucking.
You got a big old bag of pussy fluid here. What is that from? Your mama's pussy?
You don't need this shit.
Yeah, we're taking the lessons that Chris Kyle taught us to save these kids from cancer by doing exactly what they need, which is some tough love. Jenny Jones.
Tough. Love.
Uh-huh. They're gonna boot camp the cancer out of them.
And it's Jenny Jones. Okay, today we're talking to eight about cancer. We're gonna straighten them out. We got Marine Kyle coming in. And Kyle's gonna tell us what's for, you know? What do you think you're doing, pussy? You grew up to be a pussy? Stop having cancer now. Drop and stop having cancer. Just
hold my pocket.
Yeah.
None of this. No chemotherapy for you, bitch.
Now you're my girlfriend.
I'm scared not having cancer anymore. We're taking white kids to jail. You suck my dick till you ain't got cancer no more. That's what I'm gonna do to you. I love that just the guys that get
just sexual predators.
Yeah. All right, listen up, fellas. Just attention, real quick. Hey, Marcus, quiet down. So we got an elementary school coming to the prison. A couple of the kids are pretty bad. We need to know who is willing to threaten to rape and murder children to their face so they stop stealing gift cards from Best Buy.
Lie to their mom.
Or that they do their homework. We need to impose lasting, permanent psychological trauma on these kids and document it on video and replay it. So that throughout their life, you know, when they check the TV guide listings, they'll remember the day that they were verbally, sexually assaulted.
It'll go into syndication.
Who's willing, boys? Got an extra Dorito packet for you.
I remember they did that remake of Scared Straight, and they had one. They had this like little black kid, and these guys like threw him into a bathroom stall, and it's like two grown men.
What?
This kid's like 5 feet tall. They're like, when you in here, now you can't do nothing. We can have our way with you. You know, they're just they're saying that they could like rape him in the bathroom. And he's just like crying.
I saw one where a kid like swung on. I bet he'll
never tell the teacher to shut up after.
He'll never take paper clips without permission anymore. Yeah. Now that I said I was going to put my thumbs in his ass and spread them open.
Yeah. That's it. We're going to put a speculum down his throat. And then drip, get the paraplegic gang member. We're going to beat him off and let him drip nut down your throat.
The wheelchair one.
I saw one where a kid actually swung on someone, and he basically called their bluff. He's like, you can't hurt me. And then he just swung on somebody. It was pretty funny, actually. Wasn't there one, maybe we talked about on the show, where there's like a British version of this where they did not really do any homework and they sent a guy in there and he did get raped.
What?
Yeah.
No.
I think we talked about this like a year
ago. A child?
The British people, they get raped at like regular private school. That's so funny. You could go to private school in Britain and get like, there's a good chance you'll get raped.
Right.
Oh, 100%.
Yeah. And then have tea with your rapist afterwards.
Well, then you have to be an adult or whatever. And then, like, you're trying to navigate your life. You run away from your stupid fucking rich family. Like, slumming it and fucking.
Maybe that's why they had to invade everywhere.
Chester Bread or Doryburg or wherever the fuck Northern English town you end up in.
Yep.
And people are like, oh, you went to private school?
Nice.
Yeah, you must have had it real easy.
Yeah.
Why not? So I have to be Adam Sr. My origin story.
Dude, you think that's why they invaded India? Because they were like, I have to go. I'm getting away from here. Where's the farthest place? Mm-hmm. They just got tired of getting raped.
Mm-hmm.
I'm gonna
put a big feather on my head and I'm gonna be an Indian guy.
I'm gonna rape them.
That'll show them. I'll bugger them.
I'll rape them.
Man raped by inmates during Scared Straight prison tour, British Columbia.
Oh, we're gonna pull that.
Oh, so that's in Canada.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, we talked about this before, but still, it was in terms of probation in the late 1970s. Owned. I think we can squarely put that man in the owned category.
Boom.
I feel like there was more rapes happening in the late 70s and mid to mid 80s than any other decade.
You think that was rape o'clock?
Oh, yeah, baby.
Yeah, that was the...
That was the hangover from the free love generation. The golden age of rape.
Yeah, the golden age of rape.
The free love generation was followed by the golden age of rape.
It is the time to get raped in prison. We're raping everyone.
Yeah, that's some 70s style sex, right?
Fucking penis, eating asshole at knife point. Out of the 60s, you know, getting raped in jail, fucking just Just the free love movement. This is the fourth love movement of the 1960s. Yeah, I used to drive my VW bug. We got a V, me and a couple of guys, we had a VW bus, and we'd go around picking, you know, just fellow lost traveler souls, and we'd tie them down in the back, and we'd have our way with them.
Yeah, we'd usually put a shotgun in his mouth or in his ass, and then whatever the shotgun wasn't in, we'd put our dicks in. It was kind of a whole scene, man.
Like the A-team, but
yeah.
But our version of the A-team.
That's right.
Non-raping veteran.
Yeah.
The same theme there. The same.
Yeah. It would be funny if it's the same episode we talked about.
It involves a bang bus in each of them. I think that's the connection.
They say like rape van all the time. And it was just because of Silence of the Lambs.
He had a van that he raped people in?
I believe so.
Yeah, he gets the fat. He picked up fat girl up. He's like, can you help my arms fuck up? Can you fucking help me put this couch in the back of my van? He's like, oh, yeah, of course. I'll help this drink. 10 p.m. Be easier if you get in the van.
I haven't seen it, like I said.
Really? Well, you should watch it, dude. It's a Baltimore classic.
Yeah. Set in Baltimore?
Well, yeah, actually, yeah.
Hannibal Lecter's The Insane Asylum
It's set in the Mid-Atlantic, so it's all from like Virginia. I think it goes to like Southern Virginia to up to Baltimore, but I forget where it ends. Because Buffalo Bill lives in like Ohio or something.
Yeah.
Oh shit.
Yeah, Hannibal Lecter is from Baltimore.
And nice.
He's in an insane asylum in Maryland.
Fuck yeah! Maybe I will watch it. I'm thinking on Saturdays I'm going to do a thing where I watch three movies. That's my Saturday move. So maybe I want to watch Constantine. It's with Keanu Reeves where he goes to hell.
No, that's cool.
I want to watch Little Nicky.
Yeah.
Oh, that's a classic.
That's a fucking classic. I saw somebody post about Little Nicky.
Doing the Hell series.
I think I'm going to do the Hell series. So what's the third Hell? So, okay, I can't do...
End of Days.
End of Days?
End of Days is a great pick.
Really? Yeah. Who's in that?
Arnold.
Oh. Hell yeah, dude.
Was that his comeback after Governator? Was End of Days, or did that come out before?
I think 6 Days came out before that.
Whatever.
No. We're about 6 inches.
End of Days was what?
My penis is 6 inches exactly.
I thought that was his first movie after Governator. Like that. Dude, he's
End of Days came out before or it six come out. Days. 6 Days was probably what, 2001?
Is it a banger or is it like some old Arnold shit?
It's cool. I remember really liking it.
6 Days 2000, fucking End of Days is 1999.
Oh.
You should also watch Spawn.
I've seen Spawn though.
You should watch the HBO Spawn miniseries.
Okay.
Starring James Gandy as Antonio Spawn.
Antonio Spawn already?
Spawn as Antonio Spawnaduccio.
Spawnaduccio. Hey, I'm fucking in hell.
No, it's different than it used to be. You know how it used to be? It's different now. You used to have got state in Adolf Hitler. Now it's different. Yeah, it's
all these fucking child mulats.
They molest these.
Who is the honor in hell?
Where's the honor? Where's the guys that used to kill a bunch of Jews?
Now it's true.
The Jews are down here too.
Where's the ethnic cleansing? Now we got Jews in here. Where's Jewish hell?
It used to be my people that ruined this neighborhood. These people was doing all the crime. They got other guys moving in here doing a different type of crime.
Frankly, it makes me sick.
Place. You could go around breaking people's knees and demanding money from milkmen. Now look at it. It's somebody doing heroin and minding their own business and listening to music I don't like. Now it's a different. It's gone downhill.
Nobody's terrorizing blue collar workers just trying to make a living, barely getting by.
You know,
nobody's doing that to have mistresses to also beat like their wives.
Yeah. Because that's something we brought over
from the old country,
from the other side. The
only piece of culture we retained is the worst aspect of
it. No, I don't speak the language of Duchlio. No.
Yeah, no, no. And when I do, I speak it worse than somebody who's in a first class you could ever take on Italian.
I speak it worse than if you just showed a mentally incapacitated person Italian and asked them to guess how it's pronounced. I speak it worse than them.
You could shove spaghetti up an AIDS patient's ass and have him shit it out, and it would sound more like Italian spoken in Italy
than the way that I pronounce capicola. Then
me trying to fumble my way through a sandwich menu.
It's true. Most of their Italian is sandwich based.
Yeah. Well, I'll tell you what. This is exciting news, folks.
I love news.
I need to re-up my underwear.
Wow.
Oh.
And so I thought, should I buy underwear or should I talk to our old friends at Mack Weldon and just get some underwear from them?
Okay.
Yeah. What did you do?
I talked to them and they said, yes, we'll send you some. And then I think they forgot, but I am eagerly awaiting my Mack Weldon underwear because The one pair I did get from them, I ended up, because they gave, you know, you get like a little credit or whatever.
Yeah.
The sponsor. And then I think I blew it on like socks or something and only got the actual underwear, but they're great underwear. And I'm ready to throw out all of the underwear I have.
This is great news too. I'm glad they're back on the team because I have shit my pants twice during the quarantine.
I don't know
how exactly I've managed to do that.
A lot of fruits and vegetables.
It's so funny because it's like I kind of like I have this attitude of like I don't shit my pants. But the other day, it's like I went and like just at complete liquid, and it's like it was one of those ones where I'm like I should probably sit on the toilet. It might be gas, but I should probably sit on the toilet
just to be safe.
And it's just I've just hit my numbers every time, you know. And that's the nice thing about Mack Weldon is that you can't shit in them.
It's impossible.
It's impossible physically.
Mack Weldon was originally a diaper company, and then they
everyone knows that
they thought, well, what if we could actually prevent people from shitting their pants in the first place? Wow. And so there's actually dangerous chemicals.
Yeah. If shit is released, your cock will dissolve.
Yeah.
There's actually the second you shit.
Dangerous chemicals that go up your asshole when you put on the underwear that seal everything permanently, which actually makes them great if you're ever headed to prison.
Mm-hmm.
But, it'll.
Yeah. You know, if you're about to be scared straight, put on a pair of Mack Weldons.
You can't be sodomized while wearing Mack Weldon underwear.
Uh huh.
I guarantee it.
You're gonna like the way you're not getting raped. You're gonna like, I guarantee it.
You're gonna like not being raped.
That's the Mack Weldon promise.
Guaranteed. Yeah. No, honestly, I'm sitting here and I was wearing Mack Weldon underwear right now.
Mm-hmm.
And I don't, you know. I just want to get rid of it. I hate the underwear that I have. And it hurts my balls.
That's tough, dude. You don't want that.
My balls hurt from my underwear. I've constantly hurt my balls trying to make Fuddruckers at home.
Oh, I was going to ask, that have anything to do with the Fuddruckers?
Yeah. And so I need Mack Weldon underwear to fix my balls.
You're putting your balls in peril too often, man.
Yeah, they really do. I mean, all jokes aside, it is a very nice pair of underwear. I tried it on. I'm like, oh, you know, because it's like one of those things. You know, before the podcast took off, it's like, oh, I need bed sheets, so I guess I'll buy like the cheapest fucking piece of shit.
I guess I'll buy extra large garbage bags and plastic use them as sheets.
Yeah, I was gonna say.
I mean, literally until 2 years ago, I didn't know there was a difference between things.
Yeah.
Like, it did not occur to me that there was possibly a nicer, you know, like my dishware was always like fucking like. Somebody threw out a bunch of forks.
Yeah. Like 50 forks, 3 spoons. Forks,
1 knife.
Yeah.
Yeah.
You know, the good, and then all the forks that they like are coming disconnected from the handle.
Yes. Like,
set up, like fucking plates that were designed for children that come from broken homes to play house with. You know, like not even real plate, like make believe.
Yes, pre-K plates.
Fisher Price, yeah.
Eating off that. Yeah. Mm-hmm. So yeah, my approach to underwear was very similar as well. Mm-hmm. You know, you get the fucking Joe Boxer 36 pairs of underwear, including an extra one just in case. Just in case 36 in a bag wasn't enough. You know, refresh.
Oh yeah.
You're not necessarily potty trained. These are the
But anyway, they're disposable, basically.
Yeah, but that Mack Weldon shit, man, I'll tell you, that's nice.
Cradles your nuts gorgeously.
Feels good on your ass cheeks.
Yes, sir.
I have my ass cheeks slicked up by a knife.
Oh, yeah.
I said, it's the homegrown down here in Louisiana. All the cotton never touches a pair of hands. So there's a man goes through the field, got his butt cheeks out, and just rubs it. Glues up his butt cheeks.
Wow.
You know, the cotton is done stick to him. That's how you know God smiled on his ass and said, that's the cotton for your underwear.
And that's how Mack Weldon sources all of their cotton.
Correct.
And now going on 25 years that it has been the entire process, not a single stage involved slave labor.
Nope, just glue between a man's ass cheeks.
Since 1995, we are 100% slave-free labor. It's the owner of the company, super glue up his ass. Now, he is a retard boy. I'll let you know that.
That is true.
But he's getting paid.
No, he is not.
Oh.
He is allowed his God-given freedom to run butt cheeks out through that field. Which that's how you know God smiled on him.
The ultimate form of payment for the retarded.
That he found his way into a position as the butt cheek boy. Louisiana's number one.
If you have mental disabilities, your number one goal in life is to pick cotton with your ass.
How about George Zimmer? But he's like, you know, he's got like nipple clamps on and just like a little leather hat, and he's new. And his penis is out. It's Men's Bear House.
Yes. And oh, yeah.
Like, fuck me in my ass.
Yep. I guarantee. No guarantee. Or.
And we're back to Mack Weldon. Yeah, they got underwear. The underwear is good. They got a bunch of other shit. Like I said, I blew the money on socks.
Mm-hmm. The socks. How are those socks? Pants?
Socks are good. But that's the other thing, too, is like, you know, I just buy the cheapest socks. I didn't know. All their shit's nice.
Yeah, upgrade your shit, bitch. Get some Mack Weldies.
Oh, shit. Here, this is new. They got a new adjustable Storm Chaser rain jacket.
Whoa. Yeah.
I don't know what adjustable means. Does that mean it has a zipper?
Yeah, it has a zipper. First time ever a jacket has ever had a zipper. They're fucking around with zipper technology. For
being closed and open.
The Storm Chaser.
Mm-hmm.
Like you're in the movie Twister.
They actually have a line of jackets called the Bug Chaser, and that Adam has that one.
Yes, it's true. I do have that.
It goes. It buckles like a baby's onesie under your balls and ass. And actually, there's a hole in the ass part. That's what the Bug Chaser is.
It's got a slot where you can put your safe word. If you forget it, you can pull it out and say it. Yeah. Also, you can zip it all up and only have your eyes.
Yeah, it's a gimp. It's a gimp suit.
Yeah,
it's a gimp suit onesie.
It's Mac patented Mack Weldon.
Mack Weldon.
It's got silver ion technology.
Antimicrobial.
Yeah, antimicrobial.
Antimicrobial.
Adjustable Stormchaser rain jacket. These are really this is the longest lasting, highest quality items on the market.
Shit, I love that kind of shit.
Yeah, I love items, and I love it. The longest lasting.
When they're on the market and they're the longest lasting on the market. Fuck, me,
dude, I'm a player. I'm a straight up player.
I love the game.
I stroll into the market. I'm spinning my timepiece around. My penis is pulled through the fly of my and it's swinging back and forth to the tick of my clock.
Very nice. Oh, you have them set up so the clock and the cock are simpatico.
Yeah, baby. And people are like, hey, man, nice cock. Where'd you get that zoot suit? And I say, MackWeldon.com.
Yep.
And yep.
Then they go on there like, I don't see zoot suits on here. And you're like, I meant something else, but
I meant the jacket. I forgot to put the jacket on, but it's really nice.
I was wearing the suit's nice because it was raining earlier and I had the Storm Chaser jacket on, protecting my timepiece and my cock.
That's right.
My suit. So that's, but check them out.
So just check them out anyway, though.
Yeah, check them out.
Yeah, they got really good stuff. Yeah, we had good stuff. Your dick's out. Your dick's just chafing. It's bleeding because of the zipper. It just keeps rubbing up against
them. What's the word, chopper? Anybody know what time it is? I can't look at my clock because then I can't spin it anymore. I want to look at it, but I'd rather keep spinning it. If I get it, took 20 minutes to get my cock in sync with my timepiece. It's hard. It's like doing double dutch.
If I stop, I'm afraid my penis will fall off.
My penis might fall off. It's fake. My real penis is a nub.
He's so small. I had to use glue to attach it to fake penis.
Yeah, I stole some butt cheek glue off a retard boy and glued up. got a Mac Weldon, the spy versus spy guy with his dick out.
Oh, fuck. Guy versus guy. And it's two gay guys trying to suck each other's dicks.
Yeah.
Like, this is spy versus spy guys, and they're got binoculars on. They're trying to see each other's dicks. On separate buildings, trying to look at each other's dicks.
How does spy versus, does one win? Does the white one win?
I have no idea.
Or does it go back and forth? Imagine, is it like a roadrunner situation?
Whoever came up with that shit, that guy got it made. That and the dude who came up with a no fear pissing boy.
Yeah.
Calvin and Hobbes.
Yeah, whatever. Nobody knows what it's from, but the boy.
I straight up didn't know that that was Calvin or Hobbes or whoever the fuck.
It's very clearly Calvin.
I didn't know Hobbes. I knew him as the boy pissing for years.
Yeah.
I didn't know about Calvin and Hobbes.
Pissing boy and cat comic.
It's fun to just be like a hick reading Calvin Hobbes. Be like, what is he going to start pissing on shit? The boy ain't doing nothing. He's going to piss on tiger. What is he going? I know him about from the pissing stuff, man. That's what got me into this.
He hasn't pissed on a Chevy logo once.
You watch a preview for a movie, and it's got a boy, and he's done pissing on shit like the words fucking Chevrolet. And that's being pissed all over. And you watch the movie and it's some gay shit about imagination. Brother, I'm about to do a James Holmes in the movie. And that's all a bumper sticker is. It's a preview for the movie of whatever the thing is.
Mm-hmm.
Uh-huh.
That's today's sermon for you. I'll see y'all next Sunday. I'll see y'all.
Amen. Thank you. Yeah. Promo. What was the promo code for Mac Weldon?
Oh, we're still doing it. We're still doing it.
Yeah.
Smart design. Premium fabrics and simple shopping.
Yes.
Most comfortable underwear, socks, shirts, undershirts, hoodies, and sweatpants, and more than you'll ever wear.
More, you hear that?
Like regular pants. Condoms.
What if we made condoms for retarded
people? How would that work, Don?
I don't know.
Are they thicker or are they thinner?
Yeah, well, they have like safety elements to them.
Shut the fuck up.
Yes, sir.
Just everyone shut up.
Should be a safer condom.
What do you hear? Silence. And what do we do in silence?
We do don't know, Don.
I'm asking you. I've kind of. To be quite honest with you, I'm trying to get fired.
Lucky strikes. Put him in a Chinaman's ass.
Because if I got fired, I would spend all of my time at home having sex.
Yes, so true.
Most comfortable. We want you to be comfortable. So if you don't like your first pair of underwear, you can keep it. And they will still refund you. That's oh yeah, silver line. I forgot, you know, we do the other reads and there's so much bullshit in the fucking talking points. They're like, it's the best. Next bullet point. It's also good. You know?
Yeah.
Do I have to read all the shit? Anyways, but this is there.
But this, they do have the good shit.
Mack Weldon's just the facts kind of company.
Yeah, right. The silver underwear and shirts that are naturally antimicrobial, which means they make your dick look bigger.
So big, dude.
They're antimicropenisial. Which means
they shrink your thighs somehow and make your dick look big.
Yeah. They want you to be comfortable. So if you don't like your first pair of underwear, you can keep it and they will still refund you. No questions asked.
Wow.
That's a free pair of underwear. And they're good underwear too. You could scam them. You could just get the underwear and be like, yeah, I don't fucking like it. I don't like it.
Mm-hmm.
And then get it for free. Oh, and this is now we got Mack Weldon really does value its loyal customers. They've created the Weldon Blue loyalty program.
Wow.
Oh, nice. For the
well, if you scam, then you can't be in the loyalty program.
This shit doesn't need to have a name. I'm sorry. Just you can say sign up for an account and you get a discount, right? That's it. You
the Mack Weldon Blue Lives Matter program, dude.
It's Mack for the Weldon cops.
Blue. Get my dick Weldon Blue. Cut off all circular. I tie my underwear around my dick and get it Weldon Blue.
Mm-hmm.
Who was that racist children's band? Prussian Blue? Was that it?
Yeah, Prussian Blue. The two
is
sisters.
A racist children's band?
Yeah, but yeah. Then they went, I think they went Rasta. Once they
went anti-racist?
They stopped being racist and then they went Rasta.
Fuck yeah, dude. That rocks.
Pretty sick. Yeah.
Mack Weldon really does value its loyal customers. Yeah, that's why they've created the Weldon Blue loyalty.
Kind of like the opposite of Modest Yahoo.
Yeah, Modest Yahoo does not value its customers. They create an account. It's totally free. Level one, place an order for any amount and never pay for shipping again. Oh, that's cool.
Ooh,
that's great.
Hear that, Nick? Now you mad it has a name?
Yeah, I still think the name's a bad idea. These are great benefits. Level one, you get it. Place an order for any amount, you never pay for shipping again. Level two, once you purchase $200 worth of products at Mack Weldon, not only will you continue to receive free shipping, but you also start saving 20% on every order you make.
Wow.
That actually is awesome.
That's great.
Level two also grants you access to new products before they're released to anyone else, as well as free gifts added to future orders. They better give us access to those.
I'm trying to be level two.
If I have to read all this bullshit, then I better be in the Weldon Blue loyalty.
I'm trying to be Weldon. I got my balls nice and Weldon Blue.
Yeah. Why don't you? How about the me loyalty program? How
so
about
true.
You can do my program, and then I can get free access. I want the next jacket.
Yeah.
I want the parka.
I want the pussy chaser.
The pussy chaser. Yeah. yeah, the pussy chaser jacket. Personal experience. Oh,
we did it up top.
About that, yeah.
Okay, all right. So let's see here. Where the fuck is
the promo?
No, yeah, I'm looking for the promo code. Here we go. For 20% off your first order, visit mackweldon.com and enter promo code CUMTOWN20. That's CUMTOWN20. If we probably had an older promo code. This one is CUMTOWN20.
CUMTOWN20, bitch. Use that one.
Yeah.
Use that one or suck this dick. Cold steel.
They gotta check all this shit for metrics or something. But CUMTOWN20.
Yeah.
20% off your first order, which you spend $200 and you get 20% off all your fucking shit.
That's really good.
So spend $200, get 20 off,
mm-hmm.
and then you get 20 for the rest of your fucking life. You fucking idiot.
I love doing this. I wish we could just be on QVC.
Me too, bro.
That would be cool.
I get a QVC show and start drinking again. What? You fucking see this shit? It's a fucking magnet on your refrigerator. But yeah. You take it off, and it's an elevator lift for your shoe.
Very useful.
I'm always losing my elevator lift.
From a long day of being 5'6" at the office. And I see my son... I see my son for a minute for him to respect me. I take it out. I'm 5'3". And then I guess he's putting, now it's my turn to be proud. And I'm putting his homework up on the refrigerator.
Such a beautiful story.
15 payments.
That's bringing families together.
$87.99 a week for 13 years. Collection of magnets.
Mm-hmm. Can,
so you call now. We're throwing in this lightsaber I found at Salvation Army.
It's got a homeless man shit all over it.
First caller gets the complimentary lifesaver from Salvation Army, which I'm being told is actually just part of an armoire. It's not a lightsaber.
It's wood.
The clothing rack in an armoire.
A piece of wood that someone has put in their ass.
What
blue.
I like to call it is we call it the imagination shaft.
Mm-hmm.
Uh-huh.
Okay, we're always drinking. We're always thinking of stuff here at QVC. It could be different. That's the thing. The key to QVC. But a lot of people don't even know what QVC stands for.
Mm-hmm.
They say Q. How many words start with Q? Queen, queer,
quality.
Yeah. Yeah.
Quality vagina chomping.
Is that what it stands for?
Mm-hmm.
I don't actually know.
Quality yeah. vagina.
I just show up and they pay me $700,000 a year.
I don't know. Fuck yeah. They got good pussy on QVC, honestly.
Yeah, I've tried all of it.
The 5'3 lifts guy fucks everybody at QVC.
That guy runs QVC. He runs through QVC.
Just getting pussy from every bitch selling her mop or her cake pan.
Oh, yeah. No, we're all drunk. I'd like to see them try to meet to me. The police are calling QVC and they're like, are you a woman? Are you working at QVC? Call now. In the next 15 minutes, if you report a rape, you'll be able to accuse three men for free.
Yeah, you can try me, bitch. QVC's in international waters. Yeah. We're on an island floating off the coast of the Bahamas.
Actually, we're in Studio City.
Shut up, shut up. I'm trying to rape.
Shut up, man. They think the Culver City is international. I'm convinced all the women here that international waters, it means any body of water. So if their pussy's wet, there's no laws.
Yeah, but nobody's ever wet because you're fucking 5'3 and you're committing rape.
I'm trying to get some international waters, you know what I'm saying?
Sir, your mic is on. This is a hot mic situation.
Yeah, I know, I'm talking into it.
You're talking into the mic. You're admitting all your crimes on television right now.
I'm so drunk. I've been broadcasting collapsible ladders in Tupperware for 47 hours straight. And when we go to commercial break, I got a bunch of those little airport shooters. And I'm trying to look behind the craft services desk. There's a fucking pile of them 3.5 feet tall.
There's flu shots.
Yeah, I'm trying to die on air. I'm doing like a leaving QVC moment.
Uh-huh.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
That's beautiful.
You know, I told that Chinese girl, I said, you want to be my Elizabeth Shue? And she's like, I don't know what you're talking about. You smell terrible.
Yeah, please leave me alone.
Yeah.
Who is Elizabeth Shue?
She's the girl from Leaving Las Vegas.
The QVC guy's drinking himself to death and while filming QVC. He's like, maybe you can be my. And the reference only exists in his head.
Gotcha.
So she's like, what do you mean?
I've never seen Leaving Las Vegas.
She hasn't either. You're the girl in the movie.
Oh, nice.
Because you both have small genitalia.
That's not true.
It is true.
I agree with you, Nick. Yeah. What the hell was that? I didn't say that.
Sounds like you agree with me.
No, I don't.
Yeah.
What is that?
Well, I just said Stav had a small penis, and Stav said...
I agree with you, Nick.
No, I don't.
What?
I do not agree with you.
Stav, that shows growth for
Hold
you.
Hold on a second.
What?
No.
You got him back there, buddy.
No, what?
Actually, I don't agree with you.
I just, you know, right now...
Mm-hmm.
Because you only get one chance to answer...
Okay. Uh-huh. Okay.
You got a spike.
No, I don't. I don't.
I'm sorry, man. But you said you agree with me, and it was.
Well, okay. Let me ask you this: is Adam's penis small?
Yes.
I agree with you, Nick.
No, that's. You can't say that.
Maybe I can.
You can't,
Adam.
Judge that. No.
You can say that.
I agree with you, Nick. Yep, I agree that I can say that. Thank you, Nick.
I don't think there's a reason to use this button if it sings.
I like that it exists, though.
You got to add a psych at the end to cancel it out.
Psych would be good for your purposes. Not that I want to give you more arrows in the quiver, but anytime I say anything where I'm like, my dick isn't small, you could say psych afterwards.
Yeah,
psych.
I'm going to bring that soundboard back and use it against you.
Yeah, that makes sense.
That's my campaign strategy.
For what? What are you running for?
Summer of Sound. No, I mean like a military campaign.
Oh, okay. Nice. Fuck yeah.
Operation Haagen-Dazs.
I don't even like it that much. It should be
Dav, but only curry favor with Adam. And then once Adam lets his go, blammo.
That's the.
Final move. Wow.
That's a okay. Great psyop.
That's good to know, man. Now that you've tipped your hand, now I'll go to the fucking artillery shack and get more fucking guns than you, actually.
Damn.
I'm going to get a big gun.
Yeah. I wish I had I should get a better soundboard.
That's like, a good soundboard.
Well, it's only got three buttons now because it was six, but three of the slots are used up for the USB to get the sound back from.
Interesting.
I feel like, you know, with this quarantine shit, I've gone through cycles where it's like, you know, and everyone does, where at first there's maybe like a slight novelty to it, you know.
Yeah,
you,
for sure.
Fucked for sure. And you feel selfish for being like, oh, this is kind of cool.
Kind of tight, yeah.
Even though it's like, it's not tight. It's just that there's a change and it's exciting because life is.
For like a week, it feels like a vacation.
Yeah, it's staycation.
Yeah, I don't know.
It's like camping out at your house.
Vacation, it's like, let's see what's going to happen, I guess.
And I then guess, yeah.
That goes away, and then there's like frustration, and now I think I'm dead.
Mm-hmm.
I don't think I...
Acceptance.
Yeah, I don't feel anything.
That's a great stage to get to, honestly. I'm jealous of that.
Yeah.
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 Yeah, it's kind of like you, Nick, you're kind of the way every woman that fucks Adam's pussy feels. I agree with you, Nick.
You agreed with yourself. That's not that powerful.
No, because Nick nodded.
Mm-hmm. Oh,
so I agree with him agreeing with me.
All right. Well, okay. Now you guys are like tea partying. You're all right.
Oh, so to be clear, what every woman's pussy that fucks Adam feels is nothing.
What are you guys tea partying or?
What are you guys tea partying? Agreeing with each other? What are you guys at some sort of tea party?
Fox News boys over here.
Why are we the tea party? I don't get it.
I don't know why I said it. I thought tea partying is, I think it's, wasn't it from the game Foursquare?
Foursquare and 7 years ago, Adam's dick.
I thought a tea party was when two people of the four bounce back and forth between the two of them.
Well, if you call it
tea party.
4 inches and 7 millimeters.
Okay.
Sorry, everybody. It was a letter to a friend of mine who measures things. Anyways, slavery's bad.
Slavery's bad. I'm Abraham Barack Lincoln Obama.
My name is Abraham Hussein Lincoln.
It's true. He was a secret Muslim.
Love to fuck my friend's thighs. Yeah. I love putting blubber on my friend's thighs and fucking it like it's a pussy.
It's funny. It's like for a second there, I was struggling. And I'm like, fuck. What does Abraham Lincoln sound like? And it's like, oh, I have no idea.
Who cares?
It's like, why can't I do an impression of Abraham Lincoln? I can't.
He
even...
sounds like this.
He had a high pitched voice.
He sounded like you.
No, I don't have. Okay, well, Stav agrees.
Let me reiterate, I do agree.
He didn't need a button. He would have just said it. No, apparently he had a high-pitched voice.
Yeah, you know that because of Daniel Day-Lewis.
Mm-hmm. No, but yeah, that's why I learned it, obviously.
Yeah, well.
But they like...
doesn't count as knowledge if you learned it from a movie.
That's not true.
Yes, it is.
I learned a lot of stuff from movies. Herbie Fully Loaded. There's a lot of good information in that.
Like what?
I never even saw it.
Liar. Fucking liar with a little ass dick.
Herbie the Love Bug?
Yeah, it was the reboot sequel. With
Lindsay
yeah. Lohan.
I mean, the car drives up like the Golden Gate Bridge.
It's right? Pretty cool.
Didn't that happen?
I don't know.
Always
would you like it, Nick, if you had a best friend who was a car?
I'm not going to answer that question.
The answer is yes. Of course he would.
The fuck does that even mean?
You would love to have a lighter situation.
So it's in a world where there's anthropomorphic cars. One of them happens to be my friend.
Your best friend.
Honestly, no.
Why not?
Why not?
Because you want to drive it.
Well, I like cars and they don't need to be people that I can have conflict with.
There would be no conflict. Oh, it's your best friend.
It's your best friend. You guys get along great.
Oh, you know what? Everybody has conflict with.
You have minor conflicts, but you get over with your best friend.
Yeah, I just don't want to have to like bitch to other cars, being like, "Well, that's it's not even really that big of a deal." But fucking let it go. I'm not gonna let it go. So now we just have to pretend to fucking still be mad for days on end, even though we're
exactly
both 35 years old.
This is very illuminating of what you feel, of what you think your relationship with your best friend is like.
What you need is like a second best friend car who tells you and the car that the other one is really sorry but too proud to admit it.
Maybe a you need Jewish car. Intermediary car.
Maybe.
Because I think what that would cars work. Do they make in Israel?
But the problem is that that car would just run out of gas if it weren't for the other two cars pulling it around town.
That's true. Yeah, when, but
that is true. That car I agree is with you,
incredibly
Nick.
Low on gas right now.
That car, yeah, that car hasn't had an engine in it since 2012.
But every once in a while, it can come in handy.
Yeah, that's true.
Yeah, I suppose if I had that dynamic, yeah, that would be nice.
It's two cars.
I had two cars.
That would be nice.
I would like to have a car like Kit from Knight Rider, dude.
Yeah.
This pussy over here, stop, Rose.
Mr. Feeney.
Yeah. There's a girl that wants a psycho penis over here, stop, Rose. That would be invaluable information to have for my car. What are you drinking, Adam?
I left a paintbrush out.
Michael, sorry. I can feel your penis on the seat.
Is your penis getting harder, Michael?
Kit.
Kit, that's pretty fucked up that you would do
it's
that.
It's kind of sus, Kit.
Michael, are you, do you have your underwear off? Because I can feel your balls on the seat. Feels great.
It feels great.
Your car just keeps trying to have threesomes with you, which means that you have sex with a woman in the car.
Oh my god, your balls feel so good.
You're driving around naked the way your balls stick to my leather seats. It feels great.
It feels really good, Michael.
Sick song, dude.
Cool shorts that your balls are sitting kind of strange in them. It kind
Did
of
you
feels
say
good.
That it was Mr. Feeney.
I'm gonna raise the seat up so it touches your penis more.
If it's all right with you, Michael, I'm gonna turn the seat warmers up so your nuts expand and there's more surface area to touch my seat. I think it was Mr. Feeney.
Can you hear that?
Yep. Yeah.
So badass.
A shadowy flight into the dangerous world of a man who does not exist.
Hey. Damn, this shit rocks.
Michael Knight, a young loner on a crusade to champion the cause of
Oh shit, I think Currency did, he sampled this. He has a song called Michael Knight.
I remember
Knight.
That song.
Yeah, shit rocks.
What happened to Currency? He was great.
Best theme songs of all time.
Probably.
One of them. That one. Baywatch is a good theme song.
Baywatch is solid for sure.
The Hill Street Blues theme song might be my favorite theme song of all time.
I don't know it off the top of my dick.
How did that sound? Did that come through loud and clear?
Yeah.
Yeah.
It only cut off the way your shit cuts off for some reason. It was better last couple weeks, but it's still getting back to that for some reason.
Well, yours is doing it also, so.
Well, so maybe fuck you, actually.
I have an amazing life. I live in Provincetown. It's like Shangri-La.
It's a fucking ad for...
For Provincetown, Massachusetts? For the gay Cape Cod.
Hightown. On Stars. I just deleted the Stars. I somehow, like, once every 6 months, I find out I've been paying Stars just hundreds of dollars.
Yeah. You're like an elite member somehow.
No, I fucking delete the subscription, and then 6 months later, Stars is like, "What's up?
What's up?" Actually, it's been going on the whole time.
I came. I just went outside for a cigarette. I was.
You trying to fire up Spartacus?
What the fuck is this? Yeah. I'm not paying for fucking because I watched 5 minutes of Space Jam before falling asleep. I don't want my Stars membership. Just wait till it gets going.
Shit. Yeah, okay, this is an awesome one.
This Cameron could do something with this.
For sure.
I think he may have, actually.
Sounds familiar. From Harlem Streets. That's right. Right. That's why I know this.
That's right.
I don't actually know this song.
I've never seen the show. Yeah.
The show's good.
Too. Yes, dude. Yes. I'm playing. You guys can't hear, but I'm playing the Cameron one. Cameron. It's fucking awesome. They basically didn't touch it at all. It's the best.
He's funnier than most comedians.
For sure.
He's so funny.
Well, at least there's definitely one.
Other good theme songs.
Out of
honestly, Neon Genesis Evangelion, the anime I watched, has a pretty banger of a theme song, I have to admit.
Yeah, Knight Rider is too good of a theme song for the show.
It's incredible. It belongs to an awesome movie.
Yeah.
Oh, the Miami Vice theme is great.
But that's lovely.
You know what's better than that is the other Jan Hammer song, Crockett's theme.
I don't know.
From the show.
But it's also, it's not the main theme. It's this one.
Customize and save with Liberty
Fuck
Mutual.
You, Liberty Mutual.
96.
Liberty Bibbity.
Cut.
Liberty Penis. Fuck.
I finally paid $10 a month so I don't get ads anymore on YouTube.
Fuck YouTube shit. Yeah, they're like, do you get to the thing where it's like, do you want to watch 9 ads now or watch them throughout the video? And it's Jesus Christ. Are you threatening me?
Suck my dick, YouTube.
How about I just don't watch this video?
Yeah, fuck you. I'll steal this somehow, bitch.
Oh, you know it's a good theme song? Feel free to disagree. DuckTales.
DuckTales is a classic.
Yeah.
It's great.
DuckTales, I am gay.
What is it? The Fatal Farm video? That's what that in my memory. What a great.
What is that?
Don't tell him. He's not like.
All right.
The fact that he doesn't already know about it. And it's
We've talked about it on the show. We played it on the show like 3 years ago.
Yeah.
Well, I don't remember fucking 3 months ago.
Yeah. You don't remember anyone else's jokes.
Yeah. Yeah, well, I gotta save space.
You know, it'd be really funny if you did a video where the girl from DuckTales gets kidnapped by the week. She's held and sexually assaulted.
Dude, we that played it. I watched it for the first time.
Now I remember.
Show.
Now I remember. Now I remember.
It was awesome.
Yes.
DuckTales. Ooh,
I am gay.
I want to listen to that right now.
Eat my ass and fuck me. In my
suck my penis and hold me. Down and fuck me. Fuck me. In my ass. Use my asshole like a pussy. DuckTales. I am gay.
Chris McDuck is Scottish.
Yep.
Yeah, he's their Scottish Jewish uncle.
Yes, sir.
He's a miserly Scot.
I mean, Full House is a great theme song too. It's iconic, at least.
Yeah, iconic doesn't mean good, because there's shows that are like have iconic theme songs that suck, like the Family Matters theme song fucking sucks.
The Office, yeah, that's
the Family Matters theme song might be one of the worst fucking theme songs of all time.
Yeah,
it has nothing to do with the show. Is that
it? Really has nothing to do with the show.
It's like Rod Stewart, but I don't think it is.
Yeah, it's fake Rod Stewart.
Yeah, it's like and you know what?
Every step I fuck. No, that's a Full House.
Friends theme song sucks.
Friends theme song sucks hard, penis.
Yeah.
So no one told you that I fucked you in the ass.
Yeah.
I held you down and put my penis Parker inside you.
Bang the Family Matters theme song. That's the thing. Like, if you were a gay guy in like the fucking like 1970s or whatever. That's all you had. All you could do is either like make puppets for children or sing TV theme songs.
didn't Alan Thicke write a bunch of TV theme songs?
Did he?
Yeah.
No, Jesse Frederick James Conaway is his full name. He was born in Salisbury.
Oh, whoa. Shit. Local boy.
Well, he was raised in Seaford, Delaware.
Fuck you, bitch. Fuck you. Fuck off, you Delaware piece of garbage.
He died of cystic fibrosis.
Good.
Age 12. No, that was his brother. I didn't read the whole thing.
Oh, okay. Damn.
Anyway, let's see.
Every time you show.
Oh, Cheers is a really famous one.
I love reading about these guys. Yeah, these like 70s guys, you know, with their shitty comb overs and their like sweaters and their giant lapels that just made theme songs. And then you go down to personal life and it's always like, he died.
A confirmed bachelor.
Right. He died of AIDS.
He got AIDS by accident somehow.
He overdosed on AIDS.
Here we go.
Shouts out to fucking Liberace trying to pretend he didn't have AIDS.
He's married to his wife, Holly. Together, they have two grown sons, Kieran and Nicholas. So let's see who's this beard. I'm going to contact his widow and be like, admit it.
Admit that he's gay.
I'm a podcaster, and I was saying your dead husband's gay on the show, and I can't be wrong.
Tell me he's fucking gay, bitch. I'm trying to think of other. I know I'm forgetting some good ass theme songs.
Oh, you fuck.
Somebody who needs you. I can't suck your dick because I am gay.
I guess I was wrong about that guy.
He's straight.
So he was not gay. He had a happy life.
Damn, I'm getting bad at this. Getting bad at fucking shooting from the hip and calling people gay based on a song I heard. A song I heard them get commissioned to write.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. I mean, the first line is, it's a rare condition.
Yep.
I mean, imagine you're an artist and your first thought is like, what's the opening line for this show about a black family in Chicago? It's a rare condition.
And they say black and not being a criminal.
It's a rare condition. It's called AIDS. Some people have it, even though they're not gay. And they're like, they don't have AIDS.
They're definitely not gay. Don't check their personal life.
Except the one neighbor who might be gay. But then it turns out he's just a nerd.
He's not gay. And neither am I. I have a wife.
Like Family Matters in like the mid-noughts. Because then you could just have scenes where like Urkel... Like Carl tells Urkel to leave, and Urkel starts like his eyes roll back in his head, and he starts hyperventilating and trying to go Super Saiyan. Yeah. Like an actual nerd. He's got like shell braids and he's wearing like Avirex.
Yeah. Just the most fucking not tended to cornrows of all time.
Just the messiest cornrows.
I brought over Sonic Adventure 2 Battle if you want to play.
You're not even good at school, Steve. You're just a fucking loser who tries to speak Japanese.
You're in emotional problems class. Steve, you had to go to alternative school for having emotional problems. You have a parole officer because you have temper tantrums. They had to call the police to the school because you were spitting on people.
You were talking to yourself and spitting on people, Steve. You were narrating how you were getting revenge. They'll see. One day they'll stop messing with Steve. What was that, Steve?
See.
They'll all be sorry when Steve unlocks his powers.
The pitch. So basically, it's a middle class black Chicago family, but the neighbor is a black kid with emotional problems. Yeah, he's like a black nerd.
Sounds good. We'll take it. 6 seasons, please. Up top.
Yeah. Now, that show was on forever. They changed. Oh, yeah. They changed on like Rachel like 9 times.
I don't remember. No, really?
Yeah, there was a couple different ones.
All the black shows, they were like, yeah, just swap them out. Nobody's
there was a couple, yeah, a couple different Aunt Viv's.
Yeah, famously, Fresh Prince. Of course.
Yeah.
Everybody knows that, Adam. To yeah. even say that like it's information is embarrassing.
Yeah, I know.
I agree that's with you, Nick. One.
you're agreeing with your, you're calling yourself Nick.
You know, no. There's more than one Aunt Viv. Yeah.
That's really interesting
not
information.
Not what I sound like.
I'm closing my eyes. Sorry. Who said that?
Did you Adam? Pull a tooth out of your mouth?
Me?
No. This is a piece of like a flosser.
Oh, I love those.
Like what one of these?
Flossing sword.
Oh. Look like a shark tooth, and then I missed the beach. I missed collecting shark teeth on the beach.
Fuck yeah, brother. I want to get on the beach. Mahalo.
Dude, I got to get back in the Mahalo mindset.
What are you doing, pools in Vegas?
Yeah, but, we, you know.
Do you have a pool at your house?
We were always going to get it, but we never did. Everyone's got a pool. It's 125 degrees in the summer.
You should just build a pool, dude, while
I'm
you're
gonna
out there.
Dig one. I'm going to be pissed in the backyard.
Dig one, dude.
Build a pool for your father.
Like I know.
Like in the Bible.
Mm-hmm.
That's true.
Dude, like holes, like Stanley motherfucking Yelnats.
You should watch that movie again, Stuff.
No, I don't think I will. I've seen
you
it.
You should have a shy afternoon.
A shy afternoon? Mm-hmm. I do want to watch
the Rear Window remake he's in.
I remember I used to get so excited about marathons on TV.
Yeah.
Hilarious that they call it a marathon.
I know.
We're having a Star Trek push-up contest. No, you don't actually do push-ups. You just sit and watch Star Trek.
You actually, yeah, your body atrophies while you watch 12 hours.
You watch 14 hours of Star Trek Space Nine while eating, as a fat child, just the cheese packet from a Kraft mac and cheese box by itself.
The powder.
As if it were Fun Dip. Just eating the cheese powder.
Wetting yeah. your finger.
Just sticking your tongue in there and licking at it.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. And then eating ramen like chips. Eating ramen noodles like chips.
This is great. I love watching Star Trek. It makes me smarter because it's for smart people. You know?
It is a smart show.
I thought that as a kid. I thought it looks like space. I mean, science. You have a fucking genius to understand this.
This guy's that's got awesome. A French name. That's pretty
yeah,
smart.
Yeah, I mean, he's got there's aliens. You got to be yep. you got to be a genius to know how that works.
That's true. That is a good point.
I think most Trekkies still feel that way.
Yeah. Well, I'll tell you what. I have to piss a Duccio, and then I got to eat something because my
I'm hungry.
Same, brother.
It's all right. Time over here.
All right, folks. Thanks for listening. Woo!